在这个个案里头，其实我们可以看出来，美国这次的政治呢，主要的暴力来自于第一个是政党的对立。所以，一个国家出现政党对立不容易己的时刻，它其实已经脱离了民主政治，虽然它还有民主制度。第二个，这个民主政治的核心导致分裂的核心，如果是种族的话，那就是最危险的。美国现在最大的问题是反移民以及种族主义。在美国过去历史里头，有一段叫做图尔沙的历史。那段图尔沙的历史，对很多美国白人来说是不了解的历史，教科书里头没有的历史。事实上，美国曾经我们都知道南北战争解放了黑奴，可是在1921年，也就在100年前，当时美国有一群白人北上大迁徙，他们拒绝跟黑人比邻而居。那对于一些黑人日子过得太好的，他们甚至可以用私刑殴打他们，把他们解决问题。然后在图尔沙就曾经发生了以下的一个历史故事跟悲剧。 Joe Biden 今年很了解美国民主政治核心的问题，就是白人至上主义。他要白人了解，你们曾经是屠杀者，你们有任何高尚之处，白人应该从历史里头反省跟了解这件事情，而不是掩盖你们可耻的历史。
But Tulsa essentially became the birthplace of African American entrepreneurship.
There's a part of the city in the northeastern corner that becomes the primary African-American settlement, known as Greenwood.
So there were movie theaters and dance halls and barber shops and grocery stores and restaurants and service providers like doctors and lawyers and pharmacists and dentists.
These were members of a black community who were showing black people that a new world was possible. They were a sign and a symbol to black communities aboutall of the wonderful things that we could be.
那是美国白人至上主义猖獗，实施黑白隔离制度，私刑处决非议的种族暴动年代。贫困的白人难以接受比自己低等的黑人过上好生活。奥克拉荷马州图尔沙市格林伍德却有一个独树一帜的富庶非议社区。1921年5月30号发生一起电梯事件，引爆图尔沙种族屠杀。
Dick Rowan, 19-year-old black boy who shined shoes downtown. Sarah Page, 17-year-old white girl who ran an elevator in a downtown building called the Drexel Building.
We don't know exactly what actually happens, but upon entering, we think he may have tripped and bumped into the white elevator operator, Sarah Page.
A scream from Page leads to Rowland's arrest the next day.
It published a story the next day entitled Nab Negro for Attacking Girl in an Elevator.
The newspaper, the white newspapers, implies that there needs to be a lynching tonight.
Hundreds of white people descended upon Black Wall Street, armed. Black residents withdrew behind the railroad tracks that marked off the Greenwood District. Some of them were armed and fought back, but they were outnumbered by the white mob, which shot their way through. The white mob murdered. They looted.And they set fire to Black Wall Street.
We saw coming up the wall four men with torches in their hand. When my mother saw them coming, she says, you get up under the bed, get up under the bed. They set our house on fire. They went right straight to the curtains and set the curtains on fire.
And my grandpa said, we're going out of town. And he said, not to.Day, you're not going out of town. Bam!
You saw your grandfather get shot?
I saw him get shot. Bam!
Many eyewitnesses report that planes dropped what I'll call incendiary devices on the community. So these would have been nitroglycerin or kerosene bombs that caused the flames to spread more rapidly and burn more brilliantly.
Greenwood is left a smoldering ruin.9,000 people left homeless, the dead uncounted. Estimates range from 75 to 300.
The Tulsa City Commission issued a report 2 weeks after the massacre. In it, Mayor T.D. Evans was unequivocal. Let the blame for this Negro uprising lie right where it belongs, on those armed Negroes and their followers who started this trouble and who instigated it.
No white person was ever heldaccountable in terms of going to prison, serving jail time, et cetera, for the devastation of the Greenwood community and the murder of the African-Americans who populated the Greenwood community. The ultimate irony is that several dozen black men were indicted for inciting the riot.
格林伍德一夕之间面目全非，无家可归也无处可去的居民被迫接受保护性拘留，直到有白人担保才能获释。这起种族屠杀悲剧当时被称为族群冲突、武装暴动，甚至是不可说的禁忌。直到1997年，州政府成立委员会调查，报告2001年出炉，指出死亡人数估最高达300人。2000年才列入奥克拉荷马州中学课程。
I was an adult before I ever heard about it. It was something that was hidden.
I know so many white Oklahomans who of my age and even, you know, a couple of decades younger said we never heard about it.
One group was either afraid or didn't hear the story, afraid of what would happen if they actually shared the story. The other group was embarrassed by what happened. And
I'm the first president in 100 years ever to come to Tulsa.For much too long, the history of what took place here was told in silence, cloaked in darkness. My fellow Americans, this was not a riot. This was a massacre. We can't just choose to learn what we want to know and not what we should know.
屠尔杀、种族屠杀这段曾被掩盖的历史，百年后美国总统公开演说纪念，但不可否认，种族歧视在美国从未消失，只是保守右派认为种族歧视不是代代相传，美国体制也非白人至上主义的体现，这让研究种族歧视深植在美国法律和社会系统中的批判种族理论，近来掀起新一波文化战争。
Critical race theory is a concept developed by black legal scholars in the 1970s. It states that racism is common for most people of color in the United States, is woven into American policies and laws, and goes beyond any one person's individual actions or prejudice. Other scholars and activists broaden the original concept to talk about how racism is prevalent in housing, education, healthcare, and more.
For example, their supporters say a focus on race might further divide Americans and worsen race relations. Liberals say it's a mistake to forbid discussion of an important societal issue. The controversy over critical race theory could become an issue in the November 2022 midterm elections.
As of mid-June 2021, 21 states have introduced bills attempting to restrict the teaching of critical race theory and or impose limits on how race is discussed inside the classroom.
百年前，屠尔杀禁谈种族屠杀，百年后，多州计划立法为种族教育设限，种族鸿沟在美国依旧不易跨越。